Yeah, Jean-Michel Jarre. Do you actually remember this?
No, I forgot that. I mean, I remember that it was actually one of the first video ever made with the Bohemian Rhapsody.
Uh-huh.
I was very serious. Huh?
Yeah. You were.
Very focused.
Focus, yeah.
Oxygen, you know, when I put this record on in the living room when I was a teenager, then my father, who loves classical music, he used to say, if Bach had lived in the 20th century, he might have composed something like this.
Oh, yeah. Wow. What a statement.
Compliment?
I love your dad.
I do too.
But it's kind of right. I think so.
Yeah?
Yeah, because like...
Waarom? Spreek maar in het Nederlands, Jeroen.
Ah ja. In Nederlands? Ah ja, want
je vertaalt.
Well, ja. Ik vind dat echt inderdaad de kruisbestuiving van klassieke muziek met elektronica. En natuurlijk, nu wordt dat wel meer gedaan, maar toen was hij daar echt wel pionier in. Mm-hmm. En die vereniging, eigenlijk, ja, in één keer klassieke harmonieën, melodieën, met synthesizer. Dat is echt fantastisch. Mm-hmm.
Yes, thank you for saying this. But you know, I think that we as Europeans, I mean, Belgium, and in Belgium, in France, Germany, I mean, electronic music is coming from continental Europe. At the beginning, it has nothing to do with jazz or blues or rock or the US. Mm-hmm. It's coming from our classical heritage, this long instrumental track. I mean, it's the reason why that the German scene, the French scene, the Belgium scene, the Dutch scene is so prominent and so important in the world, because it's part of our DNA. Yeah, more than rock and roll, which is more coming from the US or the UK.
Wat ik zo mooi vond in de tijd, bij u en bij Klaus Schulze bijvoorbeeld, jullie hadden altijd een muur mee met materiaal. Zo, daar staan nu drie dingetjes, hè. Maar een muur, echt, hè, stond er. Mm-hmm.
Yes, actually, my mom was telling me, you know, why didn't you choose the violin? Much easier to carry. But these days, I mean, with a laptop, we can actually compose, I mean, produce, mm-hmm. distribute some music, which is actually a big change, and technology is helping us a lot these days. Also to democratize music all over the world.
Yes, but back then, Mr. Jarre, Oxygen was a real game changer, eh? And the record company didn't believe in it. They said it will not sell because there's no singer, no drama, all the tracks last more than 10 minutes, and on top of that, it's French.
Yes, on the Anglo-Saxon point of view, of course.
And it's
it was in days where John Lennon was saying the level of French rock is like English wine, you know. So we had to work a lot.
Yeah, it sold over 50 million copies. Eh? By the way, you keep performing and releasing records. There is a new one and a beautiful artwork, by the way, which reminded me of this album. I had this one as well. Equinox with all these creatures staring at us.
Yes,
maybe?
Actually, this new album is called Equinox Infinity. Uh-huh. It's not exactly a sequel, but I was always intrigued by the cover you just showed, the first Equinox, these strange creatures watching you. Yeah. And I then started this album by the visual, saying, what happened to these creatures 40 years later, and even in 40 years from now?
Uh-huh. And here they are, Mr. Jarre, and you have made...
I suppose. They're all having sex.
Yes, of course.
You've made two different covers now, with different imagery.
Yes, I mean, symbolizing two different futures. I'm quite convinced that we will be able to survive in the 21st century only if we can evolve in good faith, good intelligence, both with environment and new technology. Mm-hmm. And actually, those watchers, as I call them, I mean, are like the technology learning from us. You know, we are, these days, lots of us are spending more time to watch our smartphones or tablets than our own partner and even their family. I mean, even having sex with them. And so they are watching us, they are learning from us. And this is also an old story about artificial intelligence. Uh-huh. And then I got this kind of scenario that I created. And for the first time, I started an album with doing like a soundtrack from the artwork and the visual. This is the reason why the visual side of this project is very important.
You started from the artwork then. And how about artificial intelligence? Are you afraid, or do you think that artificial intelligence in the future will create music instead of us?
Yes. I'm quite convinced that in the next 10 or 15 years, I mean, artificial intelligence, algorithm, robots will be able to create original music, original movies, original stories. And, you know, generation after generation, human beings are always saying yesterday was better and tomorrow we will be worse. Mm. And it's not true, because otherwise we won't be here. Mm. I mean, each future has been globally a bit better than yeah. we should yeah. never forget that 150 years ago, I mean, we were probably dying at 40 years old and, mm-hmm. and dying of a cold because you had no antibiotics yeah. and all that. So there is no reason why artificial intelligence would be necessarily drive us to a dark future.
So we shouldn't bother. We shouldn't worry.
We should be optimistic mm-hmm. by subversion, I would mm-hmm. say. Yeah.